Okay. Hey viewers. So today we have Shubham Jaju. So he's a Mumbaikar and engineer and recently completed his MBA from IIMT Ghaziabad. Today he will be sharing his scoop with all of us and we will be knowing a lot of insights about IIMT Ghaziabad and obviously the experience of Shubham. So Shubham, hi, how are you?
I'm fine.
Great, great, great. So how are you able to cope up with this quarantine thing?
So I've done my position finance, so I'm using my finance skill set and pretty occupied with the markets and the everything current happenings going on, as there's a lot of volatility in the markets, so you can make good use of it.
And there's right.
good news of news going on in the sense of other markets, global trend tendencies and all the impacts and all, so I'm being fascinated with the reading and the other aspects in all the other sectors which is going on, like how automobile is impacted with this situations and all. So I'm occupied in reading these stuffs.
Great, great, great. So can you just brief the viewers about your educational background and where you will be joining and other stuffs related with it?
Yes, sir, sure. Hello, friends. I'm Shubham Om Prakash Jaju. I've done my post-graduation in finance and I've passed my engineering from Thadumal Shani Engineering College with specialization in IT, whereas my schooling and college was done in Mumbai. I'm currently placed in Cognizant Technology Solutions as a banking and financial solutions provider consultant. The pretty main domain is consultant and the role is senior business analyst. This was a campus placement offered from IIMT Ghaziabad itself. Whereas I've done my internship in Axis Securities as a business intelligence unit intern, where I was employed to handle the new broking aid scheme of Trade Debtor 20. Followed by, I am a national level chess player and I've got the opportunity to play with Vishwanathan Anand. And I've also won an international Olympiad of mathematics when I was in 10th gold medalist.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. So I guess you must be having a good hands on mathematics.
Yes, so that's the major skill set which poised me to pursue MBA.
Oh, wow. Nice. So when did you decide like you want to go for finance? So being an engineer, going to finance, and working in that sector. So what motivated you? I'm sure maths would be one among them. So apart from it, what motivated you and how were you able to cope up with the subject, especially related with finance during your post-graduation?
During the third year of my engineering, I figured out that if I restrict myself to just technical perspective of engineering skill set, it would limit my aspirations and my career goals. So, and I had a keen interest on the analysis aspect of it. During the third year, I was working on VECA, which is VECA to Environmental of Knowledge Analysis. It's basically a clustering algorithm based on the raw data which we come across through the units. So I had keen interest in stocks and basically in that markets domain during the third year itself. So I started figuring out how the annual reports look and what about the P&L statements, how are they mismatched. So I was not clear in that duration. And later on, I figured out that let's pursue MBA in finance domain, and that would act as a necessary skill set, and that would hone my skill set further on if I look forward to it. And thus I decided to pursue and give CAT later in the fourth year while pursuing engineering itself. And I gave all the remaining exams in the form of Symbioses, SIBM, Pune, NMAT, IFT, XLRI, ZAT exams. I cleared a lot of interviews also, but later on I converted IIMT Ghaziabad and chose that path to as a career ahead.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. So, I mean, when I was also a student, I used to be aspire like, chalo yaar, IIMs nahi hua, to IIMT Ghaziabad to apply karna hi karna hai. And I'm sure most of the aspirants would be filling up IIMT Ghaziabad form, and but not everyone gets an opportunity to learn from the institute. So, can you give us certain insights, especially for those who are willing to join or who would be joining? So any insight which a student knows well about the college?
If we figure out IIMT as a college, IIMT is known for competitions. If you look at Dare to Compete website, we are almost everywhere. We are winning majority of the competitions, be it Colgate, Nestle, all the big competitions like Bajaj FinServ. We have a very huge batch size, which is of around 600 people. You might be thinking that it might be the most negative aspect of a B school. But for us, it is the most positive aspect, as the major learning of our MBA or PGDM program is through peer learning. And with the huge batch size and with the huge diversity and the culture behind this backing, So we get to interact with more number of people and have more clear mindset and ideas. I personally have worked with more than 7 to 8 teams in the 2 years of my MBA while working on various competitions. So this is the most interesting aspect of IMT, because IMT never sleeps. This is the most trending thing which goes on for IMT. If you look at the IMT portal or IIM Tired page on Facebook, it's always written as IMT never sleeps, because with the huge batch size also, people would be working on case study, or they are reading in library, which is open 24 hours, doing stock analysis on Bloomberg terminals, which we have 8 terminals in our college, which is one of the most unique thing of a B school, because hardly majority of the B schools have 2 to 3 terminals. We have 8 terminals to satisfy this kind of batch size also. So college has provided with abundance of resources. We have Thomson Reuters also. People are playing basketball in the night. As it goes on, nobody sleeps. Hardly people sleeps in IMT, because it's MBA. It's a very rigorous program overall, but you get to learn a lot. And that's the most interesting aspect. We have Arcus as a canteen and Nescafe, which is open 24 hours. You can do case study competitions in the night, prepare for them, and go have a snack in the later. Meanwhile, IMT has the biggest B-school sports event, which is also known as Chakra View, where 20 to 22 colleges participate in, and we have a footfall of 3,000 to 4,000 people in the college. So it's the mega event which goes on. Compared to all other B-schools, nobody has that kind of mega event in the form of sports event. So it's also known as sports college, but with the help of competitions, it matches the power of both academics and extracurricular. So IMT is at par with other premier B-schools.
Awesome,
and it's the
awesome.
Best experience, and it has various cultures. We celebrate all the festivals like Durga Puja, Onam, be it any festival we celebrate, Makar Sankranti. There is huge turnout every time when we celebrate a festival. So it's a good college. One should fill the form and opt for that college.
Yeah, sure. I am sure this will be a big motivating factor for the students now, knowing that the infrastructure and the services provided at the college are supporting this lifestyle, that is, IMT never sleeps. Great. So let us go a bit in flashback. So when you were in your engineering, you thought of doing an MBA, you started with your CAT prep. And later on, once you got your score, you cracked CAT, and then you went on to the GDPR. So can you take us through the experience of CAT prep and the GDPR experience?
So CAT prep, while I was pursuing my engineering, I decided in the third year that I'll pursue CAT later on. So I figured out to the way the structure, how should I prepare for it? Getting a score is one thing, but the majority aspect lies in the preparation for GDPR. So you need to be thorough with newspapers. Just keep it simple. Read newspapers daily. Be it like from June to July, if you're appearing CAT in November, start reading newspaper from June, July onwards. And don't just panic yourself by reading very hardcore finance news or hardcore marketing aspect news. Start with the basics. Read just half an hour daily. And since I wanted to pursue finance, I read Business Standard and Economic Times. If someone wants to pursue marketing, they can go for reading Mint, because Mint has a lot of advertising content and a lot of marketing strategies, which the big entrepreneurs and the chairperson or CEO are coming across. So you can read across Mint. And meanwhile, look at the various advertisements which are going on. Be thorough with your content. Interact with majority of the people and get to know their aspects also, because GD is more about pros and cons. If you are on one-sided, then there would be some other person which have some different or other variation of that topic aspect. So know more about the topics, in and out about the topics. Back then, we had demonetization, GST, and other things, which were coming up. So I was making notes on that perspectives and having some facts and figures which can be used as a big quote in various GDPR. So keep it simple, just start preparing notes from June, July onwards, and have a booklet of around 30 odd pages, which you can revise before each and every interview, which begins in Jan, Feb, so that it doesn't get piled up on your, pressurize you after giving CAT that you need to prepare for GDPR. Since the scores come out in Jan, you don't have that amount of time left. So it's better to prepare beforehand, and that would enhance it.
Great. Okay. So I hope the strategies that given by you, especially for the GD part, will definitely help. Do you remember any of the questions which were asked to you in PI? May not be in IMT, but somewhere else, which gave you a learning and which will obviously a learning for which might be a learning for others as well.
So a question which I remember was something related to GDP aspect. So back in 2018, they asked me, where do you see GDP growing, in which sectors it is growing? So I was more into, I figured out that we are expanding into manufacturing sector, and as India is growing, so consumer demand is also growing up. And with Jio coming into the picture back then in 2018, Jio was a rise, Jio was booming inside. So consumer aspect was also growing up, consumer lifestyle was improving on the other hand. So this was the major question which was asked. So I gave a roughly answer of GDP to be growing at around 6 to 7% back then. Currently, through contrast, GDP, we are expecting it to be negative. That's a different aspect.
Back then, the conditions are
going to 6 to 7% with various factors like consumption, manufacturing, industrials, particularly breaking down sectors and giving a view on that, how that sectors would grow and overall GDP would grow. So this was asked predominantly in my IMT interview itself by a professor, because they wanted to know, what do you know about finance? What do you know about the economy, how it functions? So predominantly the question were laid in that direction.
Okay, great. So thank you so much, Shubham. That's it from my side. And it was really nice talking with you. And I'm sure this interview is going to help many students who are aspiring for IMT. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. All the best, students.